Now that we have made our floor plan on Dialux Evo, our next goal is to achieve the lux level, the required lux level. And the lux that I need to maintain here is 200 to 300 lux. So, and this is to be maintained or calculated by the calculation surfaces. So I have by default calculation surfaces in Dialux Evo. When I make a room, a calculation surface is made by making a room. So I have calculation surfaces in place. Now what I can, what else I can do is I can add the reflectance surfaces. I can add the materials and the colors of the walls and the textures. And then what will happen is it would give me the real reflectances of surfaces. So here I am adding the furniture, and I have opened the Dialux the catalog for the furniture for adding the I am designing a house, so I've clicked the home furniture. From here I will select the side table for my bedroom sets. Let's just scroll through these tables and see if I can find an appropriate table. So no, not this one. This, I think this will be fine. I'm going to drag and drop this. Here's my table, and let's just add all the furniture items. I am picking this chair, this rocking chair or armchair, and I would need a sofa, so let's select a sofa. And I'm going to pick two seaters as well, or three seaters. This one seems fine. And let's just save this. Now let's set the rest of the items. I'll need a bed, so let's pick a bed that is of queen size because my house is not that big. Okay, this is okay. I would need chairs for the dining table, so let's search for that. I would need an mirror too, so I think this is an okay cupboard or an mirror. And then the chairs for the dining table, and I'll make copies. I have ragged one, and then I'm going to make 6 or 5 copies of the same thing. And let's just further explore this home furniture tab. In this home furniture tab, I am going to select. So let's just select sanitary from here, and let's drag and drop out the relevant items from the sanitary tab. The first thing that I am dragging out is shower fitting, and next is the toilet. Then the wash basin. And let's drag out the shower stall. This is the shower area basically that I made using the arc in the floor plan. Now let's just switch to shop design, and in shop design I am selecting this action tables, shop shelves. Let's see if I can now these are the stuff that you would put in a shop if you're designing a shop, but I am not. But I am trying to explore this because I need to find a table that is suitable for my house plan. So let's see if I can find this in office furnitures. No, nothing relevant here. So let's just go back to objects. And from objects I am having here is street planning. And from here I am going to drag out a car for my parking area. And this is out of scope because I need to design lighting for the interior of my house. But I am doing it for the sake of doing it. So let's try to park the car in vertical direction, but this is quite long, so I'm going to delete this one and I'm going to drag another car that might fit in this parking area. So let's see if this one fits in the parking area. It seems like it is a perfect fit. Now let's switch to this isometric view and let's see how my car looks in this parking area. Now let's just add the other stuff as well. So from this edition tab I am going to add a shrub. You can see that you can add people as well. I'm adding this tree here, and this is the front view of my house. This is isometric view. Note that the laundry area has a wall over it or a ceiling over it because I made it as a room and I didn't make it like I made the parking area from the contour, from the inner contour option.
As I am in a story mode, I cannot see the things that I have added in the site view, so switch to site view to see the remaining things that are outside this house. Let's just rearrange the things that I dragged and dropped here. For moving and rotating stuff, you will need to right click on the object and then you will have to select the option of move or rotate, and then you would be able to move these things. Unlike AutoCAD, in which you need to use the move command, or you can directly move stuff around by just clicking on them and then picking the point and moving them. So let's just align these sofas and this. I'm going to place it here. This is a chair, and I'm going to make the copies of this chair, and I'm going to place it the way it is placed in the original floor plan. So I'm adding all this stuff to know the actual reflectances of the surfaces, because all these things contribute to the lighting design or the lumens that they are going to absorb or reflect, because they're going to affect the lux level. So let's just put the furniture where it should be, and I'm just copying these, and now let's just place this table over these chairs. So I have my complete dining set now, and let's rotate this bed and place it where it should be. The size is not the perfect fit, but it's okay. And let's just copy this here or move this here. And this is the side table, and I'm going to place these side tables along the sides of these beds, placing one here and the other on the other side. And let's just copy the pair to the next bed, beside the next bed. Okay, that's done. Now let's just place this in its respective position. That is, I am placing this in this room. This cupboard would be perfect here. This was not in the original floor plan, but I have added this. So this is how my room or my house is looking. Let's just place the rest of the stuff. I have deleted this armchair. I don't need it. Neither there is space in my house to place the armchairs. So I have selected this one for here. And this is smaller than the design, but that's okay. Again, and this is the shower stall. Let's just drag and move it there. And the sink as well. And in the next washroom, let's change the direction. Okay, now let's just rotate it and place it in the washroom. Perfect. Okay, now done. And let's install the shower fittings. I think this is the same, or this is the correct direction, but we can see this in the ISO view if I have placed it in the right direction. This one should also have a shower fitting. And that washroom, I didn't have the space for a shower stall or the shower area. And this is not the practice in our houses to have a shower area or the showers in the shower areas, but so I have kind of made a mix of both. I have rotated this car because it was perfect fit and too perfect to be true, I guess. So let's just see. Yes, this is not the right direction for the shower stall. Let's change the direction of this. Now I have made it right. Okay, now I have switched to the material tab, and I am going to select the textures and colors for different reflectance surfaces. Let's start by windows, and I am selecting this white window. So I'm going to apply, and by default it is going to be applied on all the windows. Yes, this has been applied. Now let's just select the texture for the floors. So I'm going to go to the material tabs again, and I'm going to select this texture. I'm selecting this texture for my flooring, and I'm going to use apply material option for applying the flooring to these three rooms, that is two bedrooms and one main hall. And let's just select a different flooring, that is tiled flooring for my washrooms. So I have selected this, and let's just apply it on in the washrooms. For kitchens, I am selecting a white colored. Maybe these are all carpets, and I really don't like carpets, so this is a personal preference. And I'm selecting this texture and applying this to the kitchen. Now let's just select the flooring for the laundry area. Considering it is outside my house, I'm going to select something that doesn't look the part of a house. So I think this flooring is okay for the outside area. And for the walls of this place, I'm selecting this bricked texture. Okay, and for the parking area as well. Okay. Now, I'm going to make the walls of the washroom of the tile surfaces as well. And let's just rotate this plan and add the tiles to all the walls of the washroom. And let's just give texture to the remaining wall of the laundry area. Now I have added furniture and I have added the floorings and the wall textures to some areas. In the next videos, we are going to give the wall textures to each and every wall, and we will add textures to our furnitures as well. And then we will light our project and we will briefly talk about the catalogs that are available in this Dialux Evo. So hope to see you in the next one.